Hello everyone, I am teaching 100 plus unique web application security issues in just 20 hours. With this course you can apply for security testing jobs or you can do bug bounty from home. Watch from lesson 0 guys, otherwise you will not be creative. Search in YouTube Uday Dhatrak bug bounty. This is a separate playlist to learn in 20 hours. Hello everyone, this is the separate playlist. I will be uploading 1000 plus POCs here. If you want, you can also watch. These are optional, but to learn 100 plus security issues, that's the previous one. That's more than enough, the previous channel, like 100 bug bounty lessons. Now we'll talk about cross-site scripting over ASEPT language. So you should also check for this for ASEPT header, ASEPT encoding too, guys. But for all together, for instead of for these three parameters, I'll be checking only for this at this moment. Now there is a page which is like ASEPT user language. There is particular page. It is showing, reflecting back the ASEPT encoding header input header field values, guys. So by default it will be EN English, like, you know, this one. So what is the code behind it? This is the function used to read the HTTP ASEPT language header and then print this. So if you see any time on the page, if it is reflecting back ASEPT header, then you can simply, I have already executed the script here, script alert 123, then you have to execute, the script will is executed, right click, show response in browser, copy, this one, we are under, now, yes, the script is executed. Now we are trying to understand how the server handles each header fields and their values, guys. That's it. So later sessions we won't talk much about all these things. Once we are good with the basics, then we will try all kinds of blind attacks for command injection, code injection, cross-site scripting, XPath injection, XML injection, kind of things. The basics are important. That's the reason. These all things are very important to check for any kind of injection attacks. As you can see, there will be always inbuilt functions to read all these parameter values like header values. That's it, guys.